Hello, Wanderers. Welcome back to the Game of Thrones mod and to a brand new Crusader Kings 3 roleplay series following Aegon Blackfyre, the same Aegon Blackfyre who led the 6th Blackfyre Rebellion against his foe Aegon Targaryen. He landed his army in the Vale of Arryn, and he led a war that lasted for a few years before he was ultimately defeated, sent to the Night's Watch, where he promptly escaped, going north beyond the wall. While there, he slew the husbands of the daughter of a high chieftess and took those daughters as his wives, then managing to rally a force of wildlings around him and some loyal supporters who fled north beyond the wall with him, he has been able to carve out something of a small realm for himself here, based around Hardhome and Storald Point. And so this Aegon Blackfyre finds himself in a position of a reasonable power here among the various wildling lords, chieftains, magnars, and he will still have his work cut out for him if he wishes to return to the position of glory that he was once at. He really had a chance. He had an opportunity here to take the throne for the Blackfyres, but he wasn't able to rally really much support at all, and or at the very least, not enough to defeat the forces arrayed against him. And so when Aegon the Sixth came with his army to the Vale of Arryn, well, Aegon Blackfyre was defeated, as you have just heard. So, what is he going to do from here? Well, that's a very good question. Let's take a look at our character first so we can get a kind of sense of this man. Aegon Blackfyre, he is brave, he is ruthless, and he is ambitious. So, one can probably safely assume that we are going to be doing some conquering and getting many of these wildling tribes beneath our banner. You'll also see that we are a dutiful captain, an overseer. We have the rough terrain expert, which is actually quite useful. We are a deserter. This is mostly a negative trait. We do gain some opinion with other deserter characters, but there aren't going to be many of those. But even better, we are athletic, handsome, and we are quick. So we have some pretty good traits there. And we are a trained fighter as well, so we actually have pretty decent prowess. Our stats are likewise quite good as well. And you'll see that we have ourselves 4 wives. 3 of them are the daughters of the High Chieftess of Bleakwater here, which is a pretty powerful realm that gives us quite a strong alliance. All 3 of her daughters are our wives. You'll see that we have slain some of their husbands as well. And that has given us quite a bit of notoriety, I would imagine, here. We also have taken the daughter here of the High Chieftess of the Jagged Hills as a wife as well, in order to gain an alliance here. So that is kind of our family. We don't have any children yet, but hopefully we will have some to continue the Blackfyre line so it does not die out. Now, what is the goal for our character? Well, the thing is, and you'll notice here that our character has converted to the far northern old gods. Indeed, we have come up here to the north. You know, we fled the wall, and we're not a character. I imagine this isn't a character who was particularly faithful or religious in any sense of the word. So converting to the far northern old gods is more practical than anything else, because these are the people who we're going to be interacting with, ruling over. Well, obviously we would convert to their gods. And you'll see our culture is North Valyrian. Now, this is also kind of going along with us adopting some of those wildling practices and really kind of immersing ourselves in their culture. But we have kept the Valyrian language, and I think that goes to add to the mystique of our character, what with our purple eyes and our silver hair, speaking this Valyrian tongue. I think it goes to making our character, you know, adding to his prestige, adding to his majesty here, and winning over some of those wildlings who, you know, might look upon us as, you know, something more than just a man, at least the ones that we can convince of such. I'm sure that there are plenty of cynical wildlings who see us nothing more than an interloper from the south, which, you know, some could say that we are. So we do have this North Valyrian culture. There aren't really anybody following that culture, and no provinces follow it. It's really just specific to us, but perhaps we can start to spread it. I imagine it's something similar to the Magnaric culture and the Thenn culture here. And that might end up being a pretty good kind of analogy for, you know, the Thens speak their own language. They have their own religion where they worship the Magnar as more of a god than man. I can imagine something like that springing up around Aegon Blackfyre here. What with such a unique look and the fact that we are, you know, we're athletic, we're handsome, we're quite intelligent, we're ruthless, brave, we're a strong warrior. All of these different things kind of add up to us being, you know, worshipped just as much as we are respected, at least by some of these people. So, you know, the Magnars have had a long time to build up that, but I imagine that this is kind of the start of something very similar to what the Thens have going up here. Let's see if we can continue it. So that leads us to that larger question. What is the goal for this character? He tried to take the Iron Throne and he failed. Well, I think we are smart enough to know that at the moment we don't have any power here, we don't have enough power to go up against King Aegon. Indeed, that would be almost an impossible task. So I think that it would make sense for our character, rather than trying to make another vain attempt to try to take the Iron Throne, at least right now, perhaps we do try to position ourselves as a potential king beyond the wall, form our own kingdom here, one that even rivals, I mean, it'd be tough to rival the Iron Throne, but one that rivals anything that the lands beyond the wall have ever seen before. Can we pull something like that off? That remains to be seen, but we shall get time going and see what happens here as the story plays out. But yeah, we are going to definitely be doing bringing some of these wildling lands beneath our banner here, and potentially doing so quite soon. We could take Huskmere here. I mean, they've got no troops left. I mean, we might as well just go and usurp these lands. I really don't see any reason why we would not. Let's bring up our army here, and we'll go and see if we can take those lands for ourselves while they're already being kind of manhandled by some of their other enemies here. So we'll raise up our troops, and then we will go and take Huskmere for ourselves. Chieftain Halleck might join as an enemy, though. Well, it's a little bit concerning, but not really that much. We're going to go straight in for the capital over here. Ah, and my wife, High Chieftess Ygritte, is holding a child, holding a child within her belly anyways, which is good because she's got the hail trait, so really they could get any one of these. One might hope that we will have a child worthy of being our successor here. Chieftain Halleck has indeed joined in. That's fine. I'm not really too worried about that. We're going to just head over here to the capital and Warg's Hall and try to take it for ourselves. We've got a pretty strong army. I'm not too worried about it. You'll see that we even have, I believe it is indeed the Dragon Guard. Indeed, we have our Dragon Guard that we, you know, the last few remaining soldiers that remained. Oh, that's unfortunate. Our child was, did not make it to birth. But yes, as I was saying, the last kind of remains of the loyal followers who came with us from Essos to Westeros to kind of push our claim, the loyal ones who followed us here now north beyond the wall have become the members of our Dragon Guard. So that is quite going to be quite the advantage, I think. And going forward, we will try to expand the Dragon Guard with loyal wildling soldiers if we can find some. But I think the Dragon Guard will kind of remain fairly small and really representative of those who followed us here to the lands beyond the wall. Another one of our wives is pregnant. That is excellent news to see. We want to have a bunch of children to continue this Blackfyre line. The main reason I wanted to play this character and why I found it so, thought it would be so interesting beyond just kind of playing a deserter beyond the wall, like a Mance Raider style playthrough, was the idea of the Blackfyre line kind of continuing beyond the wall. And, you know, whether or not we play future characters from this lineage, it'll be interesting to see if we can build something here that will remain for a while. If we ever go back south of beyond the wall to play some other houses, maybe returning once again to House Peak down here, which I'm sure more than a few of you would be interested in seeing. But we will try to do our best to keep the line of the Blackfyres existent here, so perhaps they can come back in the future. I think we are going to go for a battle here with the allies of our enemy. Maybe we'll be able to get enough war score here. We'll go and take this little army here. Oh no, this is their main army. Yeah, all right. Let's go and crush them here. And then we shall move on to assist our allies if we can. Another of our wives is bearing our child, and it looks like we inherited some land from one of our vassals who unfortunately did not survive the battle, it appears. Yeah, there we go. High Chieftess Morna. Oh, and there we go. Victory in that battle. Let us enforce our demands here and take those lands for our own. We do have more titles than we can hold, so we need to give this away to one of our loyal people here. And you can see there are some North Valyrians here. These are essentially wildlings who have learned the Valyrian language in order to ingratiate themselves with us. So these are essentially sycophants who are trying to earn our favor. Well, you know, I think we can give them some favor for that. We'll probably give Ygritte here, one of our captains, this land here. I think she even might have done something good in that battle there. So, and then we will take our army and we will move north to assist our allies. Maybe try to siege down the enemy capital here. They do have quite a large force. And we have a son. Interesting. I think we are going, well, so this is our heir. So I think we are going to name you Daemon Blackfyre after the original Blackfyre pretender here. You know, putting no small pressure on this young boy, but hopefully he will live up to the name better than even his forebear has. So he did inherit the comely trait, which is, you know, at least it's a little bit of a bonus there, so not terrible. Let's see if we can pull off a victory in this battle here. Luckily, the enemy has kind of separated themselves, so we kind of get to deal with them half and half here, which might just give us enough of an advantage to pull off a victory here. Oh no, but one of our wives was slain in the battle. You proved your valor, my love. Ugh, that is unfortunate to see. I mean, we can't keep our wives out of the battle. They are wildlings, after all. They fight alongside us. That seems to be the case. Anyways, I think we're going to take Stalwart Leader just to get that extra prowess here. It's probably going to be useful. We're probably going to be doing some battles. And that boosts us up to 25, which is going to keep us hopefully pretty safe here. Oh, look at this. We're just, in these Game of Thrones battles, you just lose people so quickly. And honestly, it can be tough, but you know, it's not, I kind of like it. Battles should be dangerous. I don't really ever get worried about going into a battle and being in danger in the base game. I've never really, I mean, it does happen sometimes, right? Like you sometimes get into duels, you sometimes get into battles, but it's not that often. In any case, yeah, we've inherited some more titles here as well. We're going to have to give out this one to, oh, let's say, do we have any strong warriors here? Seer Hound, Garrick, Horseman, we could. You know what, he is, we could give it out to you. Yeah, very well. Grant the title. And yeah, we'll need a new spymaster. Garrick probably could be pretty good at that. But we should put Chief Dizval because she is a little bit better or more powerful. So we want to keep her on our side. And then for our steward, they don't have tons of great options. So we'll put you in there for now. We'll siege down this enemy land and hopefully that will give our allies the victory here. So we'll speed some time up here. But yeah, overall, our goal, I think, with this character is really to... Oh, don't want to do that. The goal with this character here is to form a strong realm here in the north. And potentially, you know, potentially one day use that to strike south of the wall. If we see weakness, if we see weakness beyond the wall, we will strike. But we want to... you know, keep the Blackfyre name strong. We want to keep this dynasty going so that we have an opportunity to claim what is rightfully ours and has been for so many years. The Targaryens are not fit to hold the title that they do. And so we will attempt to take what we believe to be ours. It seems our poor daughter here is quite sick. Well, we engage in another battle here. No doubt we will find victory once more. The Dragon Guard is, the great warriors of the Dragon Guard are simply too much for the enemy to handle here. Looks like we have our victory here. We don't even need to finish this siege. Oh, my dear Morna. She appears to have died from internal injuries. Wow, we've lost few of our wives, you know, we bring our wives to battle. I don't, you know, that is kind of the wildling way to some extent. At least it appears to be from the wildlings from Bleakwater, who are, you know, pretty badass, but we've lost a few of our wives, but that does give us potential to gain other wives and potentially alliances as well. Alliances which can serve us in the future here as we seek to build our kingdom beyond the wall and potentially a kingdom south of the wall as well. But that will have to wait for another episode. If you enjoyed this one, please do like the video and subscribe to the channel because we will have more Game of Thrones mod and Crusader Kings series in general. We do try to have episodes as often as humanly possible as well. So keep an eye out for the next one of these. Until then, Wanderers, I'll see you in the next one.